Happy freaking Monday, everyone. Welcome to Let's Play Dungeon Hack Redux. My name is Duke of the Bomb. And by the end of this week, if everything goes according to plan, this LP will be finished. If everything goes according to plan. Which, you know, I'm no longer protected from petrification, so if there's another petrifying enemy, that could be an instant game over. Hopefully we won't run into anything like that. I'm going to go on ahead and rest, and then I'm going to save. So if I do die, I will already have all of my buffs and everything active by the time I start the next video. I won't have to go through the whole song and dance every single time. Not that I think I'm going to die. I'm pretty confident about my chances this time. I want to stick with the two hammer style. I think that's been working out pretty well for me. Like I said, I probably should have done that from the beginning. Because, I mean, in any combat situation in D&D, what you always want to do is focus fire on the most pressing threat. Or rather, focus fire on the thing you think you can kill the fastest. Unless it's just, cannon fodder. Then you want to go after the next biggest threat. But if you focus fire and you deal as much damage to one enemy as possible, then that's one less enemy or one fewer enemy you have dealing damage to you for the duration of the fight. When you spread your damage around, you're going to have a bad time. So naturally, that logic should also apply to Dungeon Hack. You want to deal as much damage as possible, as quickly as possible. Because, I'll drop this coin, who cares. Because the more damage you deal, the more quickly, then the less damage you will take. That's just logic. Man, trolls again? Really? There's three levels where trolls were one of the enemies? Well, I suppose I really shouldn't be complaining about that because it could be fears again. I would much rather fight trolls three times and fears twice. Sounds like some sort of homespun wisdom. Three copper keys, really? Three copper keys and an iron key? Well, that's a new sound. Or it's a sound I'm not familiar with anyway. But I think this is definitely the most keys the game's thrown at me in the first 5 minutes of a dungeon. I'm not gonna even bother getting that food. I should probably just drop my food too. I have crave food and water. I'm never going to need rations again. Wow, I mean, this is just, the game is parodying itself at this point. That's what, one, okay. How many keys has it given me so far? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And half of them are copper keys. Bravo, game. 9. Oh, man. Oh, hey, a place to put a key. I should just start a pile of all the crap I'm not going to take, because my inventory's getting full. Oh, it's a spot of confusion again. Oh, man, it's just a bone naga, really? I fought that thing... Okay, so instead of mixing up the enemies, it's decided to... mix things up in the late game by turning up the key amplification variable by a billion points. The ion stone absorbed the energy in the spell. Huh. Wonder which ion stone that was. Actually, Actually, I'm not even really sure what spell that was. I theorized earlier that it was a magic missile, but I'm not sure if there would be an ion stone that absorbs a magic missile. I don't know. Hey! There's a place to use one of our copper keys. Well, I guess I should be thankful. Although, that just means I have another ion stone that's going to burn out. It's kind of a depressing thought. I guess I should move more. Like I was trying with the Ettins. See, you think... Going by normal RPG logic, you think the troll shouldn't be able to do anything to me at this point in the game. Because I fought them so far ago. I mean, that'd be like if you were playing Dragon Warrior and you were 3/4 of the way through the game and you ran into a slime. What the f- What? Did you guys hear that? Am I losing my marbles? Was that part of the music? Or no, that couldn't have been. There's nothing like that in Secret of Mana. What the frick? It sounded like... I don't know what it sounded like. It sounded like something I would hear in a nightmare. I mean, not like, I'm running from a monster kind of nightmare, but one of those boring nightmares where you're just running endlessly through a labyrinth of some kind, and you just hear noises, and it's more annoying than scary. A night irritation. I was holding on to the crystal key because I thought I saw crystal lock around there somewhere, but I guess I've gone past it. Oh well. That was one of the weirdest noises I've heard so far. At first I was like, do I have a browser window open that like a video just started autoplaying or something? But no, everything's closed. Really hope you guys hear that in the video and it doesn't just sound like I'm slowly going insane. I mean, it wasn't the Naga or the Troll, because I've dealt with these guys before and they never made it. It must have been whatever the boss of this level is. Probably like some sort of Death Knight or possibly a Mind Flayer or something like that. One of those really scary high-level enemies that messes with your noggin. Or flays it, in the case of the Mind Flayer. Because, you know, I assume it has to flay your head in order to flay your brain. Or maybe it just flays you psychologically. Maybe there's no physical interaction with your brain at all. I wish I could just stack keys. Put this gold key on top of that one and it'll put a little 2 on it. Actually, I wish I didn't have to worry about the keys at all. I wish they just went to the screen tab on my inventory and were just used as needed. Actually, I don't know if a Death Knight is so much one of the scary, mess with your mind kind of enemies. I think it's just a tough undead. Like a tough skeleton. Still, I think Death Knights and Mind Flayers are... There it is again. Okay, so I'm not crazy. Is it below this crate? No. It's just the same dumb fountain from before, so. I don't know. I guess whatever it is, I'll find it eventually. There's that crystal lock. Oh, I have a key shaped like that. It's an opal. Not sure what that has to do with spiders, but there we go. Oh, now I can figure out what that attack was. Maybe. It might not even say what it is. Probably won't, to be honest. If it's like a fire or ice attack or something, I don't think there would be any indication as to what that was. There's like a skittering sound that sounds kind of like the scorpion monster again. I'm not sure if that's the same thing that's making that weird murmuring noise or not. That might just be the bone naga, actually. It might be like a trying to do a rattlesnake kind of effect. I'll throw my field plate at you. That'll show you. Oh crap, something drained my strength. That is better armor though. One better than my magical plate mail. So I'll hang on to that. I wonder what. Oh, that might be something the snake's attack is doing. That's what my ion stone was protecting me from. It was protecting me. The Mace of Foos! Yes, finally a named item. About time. About time I find something cool. Brigandine? That's crap. For that, and here, treasure. Oh, it's another shield. Cool. I doubt it's better than the shield I already had, because my current shield is magical. But, just for giggles, yeah, my other shield gives me a -2. And that one just gives me a -1. Not that I'm using a shield right now, but if I do use a shield, it will be my current shield. Let's say either brass or bronze, right? That's nothing that I have. Okay. So I have to come back here. Oh wait, there's a niche too. Oh, it's empty. Oh well. Picture my character feeling around blindly to determine if there's anything in the niche. Okay, so the Mace of Foos did 2 points of damage. Did 1 point of damage. 2 points of damage. Of course, I have no idea if this is more or less than my hammer's doing. Maybe the troll just has, like, incredibly tough skin that serves as natural armor or something. This is the shit hitting the fan music in Secret of Mana. At least it told me that it's a named item, and it's not something that I'd have to identify to figure out that there's something special about it. Alright, so I can't go either of these directions. Where else can I go then? All the blue dots are just littering the map. Just the garbage that I have to start throwing out. Alright, so I haven't been down this hallway. There are two doors up here that I might be able to open. Okay. I'll try the Maze of Foos for a little while longer, but you know, maybe this is a situation where having Gauntlets of Ogre Power would actually help, now that I'm using a melee weapon. Worth a shot, I guess. It still says my strength is being affected by something, but I don't know what. Okay, 10 points of damage, that's a little better. 13, okay. I still don't know, I really have no way of knowing if it's better than the hammer, other than just intuition. Magic leather armor. There's no way that's... yeah. Wait, why is my strength... or why is my armor class -3? Wasn't it way more than... oh, because I switched out my gauntlets, that's right. I mean, I'd like to use the Mace of Foose now that I finally found an actual weapon in this game. I mean, I've been relying on the Spiritual Hammer pretty much this whole game. It'd be nice to switch things up a little bit, but honestly, if I have to lower my AC to do any worthwhile amount of damage with it, and I don't even know if that's more damage than I was dealing, I might just have to go back to double hammers. I don't know. Or bracers. Are they bracers of super ogre strength? No, but I think the AC on them is better than the AC on my other magic bracers. Let me check. Alright, so where did I put those things? These, right? So, -3, -5, these were -6, right? Yeah. I think I'd rather have the AC. Don't need these. Sorry, Mace of Foose, I'm sure you're awesome for somebody, but I'm a cleric. I have the power of an angry god, making me the most OP class imaginable. Well, I don't know if my god is angry. Just chaotic. Just, you know, one of those chaotic good gods that are so plentiful. Okay. Good to know. Ogre slugs are strong against blunt weapons. Oh, I thought I saw a niche around here somewhere. Alright, I should probably start thinking about... Well, I still have two heals, right? Yeah. I'll pop one of those. Then after I use my last heal, I'm going ahead and rest up. I guess this level's... Sad to say it, but the trolls are more challenging than either of the new enemies I fought on the previous level. I'll go ahead and eat this food. My food bar is getting a little bit low. And I mean, it was just sitting there for the taking. Stone key. I don't have one of those yet, do I? Nope. Alright, but I did pick up that... Oh, that's where the gold key goes. Nice. I see you trolling. I'm gonna have to give you the ban hammer. That's pretty clever joke, actually. I'm a little proud of that one. That switch makes me very uncomfortable. I don't like having to grab a clown's tongue to open a door. However, I do want when I make my first million and I'm designing my mansion, my Bumpington estate, I do want to have a door with a handle or a knob that's just grabbing the tongue of a clown. I think that would be pretty funny. And then behind that door is just a storage closet. The tongue of the clown will confuse people, but make them curious as to what could be behind that door. Wow. That kind of hurt. Let's, go ahead and heal myself. How about... But you know, as annoying as the trolls are, this is still, you know, after the fears, I am amenable to anything this game wants to throw at me, just about. Stone key. The snake's hitting me more now that my armor class is -6. That's not right. Is it opposite day? Is a low armor class bad now? Did this game figure out intuitive mechanics since the last time I played? Like, lower armor class is good. The heck were we smoking? I guess it's kind of like your golf score. You know, a low golf score is good. That's counterintuitive, but everyone seems to be used to that. Speaking of golf, really want to pick up that new Mario Golf game on the 3DS. On the threeds. Game was pretty fun. I never played the Mario Golf game that everyone remembers fondly, and I probably should. I don't know what system that's for though. Was it the SNES or was it something that came later? There's that switch again. Listen, buddy. I don't like this any more than you do. But no, the Mario Golf game that I remember fondly was, well, it wasn't even called Mario Golf. It was called NES Open. And it was on the Nintendo Entertainment System. And the only connection to Mario was that the golfer character looked like Mario. And I mean, it didn't refer to him as Mario or anything. We just always called it Mario Golf because the dude looked like Mario. It's kind of like how in Punch-Out, the ref looked like Mario, but the game never really acknowledges that or anything. It's just something video gamers just kind of know, like, hey, that's Mario. But yeah, Mario Golf. I mean, NES Open was just like a straightforward golf game. There were no RPG mechanics or anything like that. And the Mario Golf game that everyone speaks highly of, I believe, has some sort of light RPG mechanics. You like level up your putting ability and stuff like that. I believe that's what I hear anyway. I've never actually encountered that game. Kind of weird how all of my spells seem to expire at right around the same time. And just coincidentally, it happened to be around the time I was out of healing magic and I had to rest again anyway. So, very happy coincidences. It's a bummer that two of my ion stones burned out. Wonder what my last Iron Stone does. Oh. That's just the Etten? It never made that noise before, did it? Or was I too busy yakking and I just never noticed? Cause I mean, now that I think about it, it does kind of sound like a two-headed creature arguing with itself. A little bit. I can kind of see what they were going for. Well, these are more gauntlets of ogre power, but I already have a pair. Alright, so -3 19 armor class. Or 19 strength, -3 19 strength, so they're exactly the same. See, if I had gauntlets that both had the ogre power ability and matched the AC of my current gauntlets, then that would be the best of both worlds, but obviously That's asking for a little too much. Is it just me or were those trolls getting tougher? There's nothing else No, that is the entire map. Except for this tiny little section that's blocked off that I have no way to access. Alright, well, we are well on our way. Level 16. Only three more to go, counting this one. I think I think I said three more to go last time, but... But I wasn't counting the level I was already on, so it was actually four more to go. I don't know. Anyway, I'm Duke of the Bump. See you guys tomorrow.